What is going on? Yeah, I know we finna get into it in a sec, but got some good videos lined up, some good musics, so just feel it, bro. Let it sink in, dude. You know what I mean? If you need me, look, bro, you know where to find me. I'm in a swamp, bro.
It's getting late. Yeah, I'm swerving through the rain. I see a better spouse, and they say you change. I'm unchained with a loose screw, smiling through the pain. I'm not the same as I once was. Tell me I'm okay. Hey, look, my eyes when I was dying. Now they wish they would have stayed. See through a fake like x-ray. Can't play no games, it's x-game. Too fucked by with my ex, and she lost you like a next game. I know they all gon' wish me dead. They all changed up when I was next. I spot the funds, but bitch is hella. Bitch, this new good got propellers. I can't hear, see these broke boys. I feel like Helen Keller. It's SGB and that's forever. Got no emotions like I'm better. This Caltech make my ears ring. They never care what I think or how I felt. Nah. If I talk to my mom like that, I'd get the belt. Oh, oh. And if you did the shit I did, you go to hell.
That's a Kevin Gates gif right there. That's how you know it's a bot for real.
She call me a gentleman, but she ain't see me in the streets. She would call me mental man. If
if you survive when I slide. I hope you get better, man. I hope you get better, man. So I can come and slide again. Dirty ass little 45 is tucked up in my headies, bro. Don't get slimed in headies, bro. In my $1,000 jeans. Yeah, don't get slimed in headies, bro.
Bitch, my jeans filthy. 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 Bitch, my jeans filthy.
Bitch, my jeans filthy, bro.
Bitch, my jeans filthy. Bitch, my jeans filthy.
Bitch, my jeans so filthy, bro.
You know we live with it. Oh, this for sure a Kevin James gif right here.
MySpace Mark.
Seen her gloves up. They turning me up. In that Ford running. We gon' spin that trip. I don't get no fuck. No, don't show it love. In the tunnels by the sewage, bitch, I'm off the drugs. Corey Lowers on the coupe, bitch, I'm scraping. When I'm walking, you can hear the sound of spray cans. It smell like Lysol. Off the pills, I'm weightless. Bitch, I'm in the club, you ain't even on the waitlist. 925, you wear stainless. Just like Picasso, yeah, yeah, paint the whip. Red on a hoodie, please don't fucking push me. Got that bitch so mad, cause I ain't eat her pearl. Get out my bedroom, confusing me with questions. I let my dreams, like Inception. Look into the mirror, no reflection. Now we owe for rich, it was destined.
She off the drugs. Yeah, yeah, I want jello. Because I don't care what you want. Off the top, money left. Yeah, yeah. You pull up deep. That bitch thought she knew me. But you don't know, know me. We run around with gloves up. I could run around with top down.
Alright. Let's get into this. I've done enough of these. Okay. So the reason why I wanted to come on here today. So I've given a lot of information out recently through my means of YouTube content. A lot of it was researched through accredited scholars as well as dependent Ivy League professors. And as I've gone through this research, you know, I've learned a lot, not just to benefit myself, but those around me. And I'm really excited to continue to share this research. So if you've been following the developments, you've learned a lot, and I've actually been getting a lot of comments recently concerning one of the themes of this research. Basically, guys are confused because they've been following the steps that I've laid out as guidelines, and they've worked. And now that they're getting all of this pussy, they're like, what do I do? Like, they're not sure exactly what to say to all of these bitches that are trying to fuck them. Now, I'm sure if you haven't seen the past content, you're probably confused right now. The biggest thing I've been trying to push is the monumental effects of pre-sticular testicular aromas, which are sometimes considered as nut stank, nut sack must, balls smell. Basically, I mean, you get the point. What you're going to want to do, what I've been advising is daily masturbation multiple times a day, as many as you can fit in. You know, I'm talking, you know, if you can only get in five, that's okay, but I'm talking more. And then on top of that is the absence of showering. Now, if you're able to go a week without showering and in that week hit, you know, 50 nuts, by the end of that, your nuts will smell powerful. And the thing is, here's the thing, that stench to us would be considered a bad stench. However, pheromones are created within... What the fuck is this shit, bro? Who is this? This is ass. The fuck? Ruined everything, bro. Ruined my concentration. Fuck was that shit, bro? Anyways. This shit isn't popping either. Fuck. Bruh. Man. Where's the goddamn stream playlist? Anywho. By concentrating these pheromones, right, through the absence of showers and the consistent masturbation, your aroma is actually a conduit for said pheromones. And as you enhance this aroma, as you develop it, find what works for you. Whatever you end up doing, as you, what you will see is as you go out, bitches will be trying to fuck you without you even saying a thing. Okay. For example, when I first came across this research, I tested it myself. I went downtown to the bar. Down in Atlanta, there's a bar. I went there. As soon as I walked in, what I didn't realize is that my ball sack was emanating out into the bar, and bitches could tell, but they didn't smell, you know, stinky ball sack. They simply were consumed by the pheromones. You know, it enters through airways. Hits nerves and is immediately retracted to the sympathetic nervous system within the neurons in their brains. And when I walked into the bar, almost immediately, bitches were looking at me. I sat down because I didn't know what was happening. They started to gravitate towards me. I was so confused. And then the moment I realized that this is life-changing is when I was sitting at the bar. This bitch, she sits down next to me. She turns over and, you know, she, like, sits on my leg and her pussy's dripping on my leg, you know. At this point, my leg is drenched and she's just, like, rubbing up on my leg with her pussy. It was insane. You know, and other bitches too, they were like, you know, I've talked about it before as well. This aroma is able to cause liquidation of pussies, aka pussy sweat, due to the vibrational impact on tentricular vessels within pussies. They vibrate, inducing wetness just by you, you know, being in the vicinity. You know, it happens to me a lot. One thing I haven't mentioned is that that vibrational force that's enacted on the pussies is also enacted on tits, and bitches will lactate. Okay, it's dangerous. I mean, it's really dangerous to use these techniques if you don't know what you're doing, because you will freak a lot of people out. Okay, they won't know it's you, but people will freak out because you'll walk into the bar. You'll walk into the party. you pull up to the house party and bitches are like embarrassed and everybody's like, yo, what's going on? Like everybody's uncomfortable, and then it turns out they're all like got milk coming out of their tits because of your nutsack stench. Now, okay. Now here's where I was trying to get with all this is this is a lot of guys have been following my techniques. You know, it works out for a lot of men, for pretty much anyone who decides to do it. Well, not just pretty much, but anyone who has done it. 100% conversion rate. But the thing is, you know, once these guys have bitches all over their dicks, you know, a lot of them are like, okay, what do I say in these situations? If there's a bitch who isn't particularly entranced, you know, what do I do to persuade her in order to allow this stench to attract into her particular nervous system? Because that is what happens, you know, you say a couple things, right? They see the drip. They hear the charisma, and they're more open to these frequency pheromones. So here's my advice. Here's what I'm gonna discuss with you guys today. Hold on. So when this first started happening to me, I didn't have that problem because I get bitches, you know? And so when all these bitches were trying to fuck me, it was more like, how do I get these bitches off my cock, you know? But for a lot of guys, it's different. You know, they're not used to this. And I'm here to help, man. So let's say you walk into the bar and you see a 10. Now by this time all the other bitches are like trying to smash like for real, but there's this one bitch and you're like, why isn't she entranced yet? So here's what you want to do. Take in mind all these bitches want to fuck, right? So that's already a plus, because all you got to do is wave these bitches off, like, get off my dick. The 10 will see that and take note of it. Now, what you're going to want to do is you don't want to sit next to the 10. You don't want to show any type of interest. Okay, you sit not on the complete other side, but like 3/4 of the way away. Maybe like halfway across the bar, right? Now, because of your pheromones, she's not necessarily induced, but there are effects, and she is magnetically, emphatically drawn towards you. So all you have to do is sit there, and slowly but surely, without her knowledge, she's going to move towards you slowly. You just sit there until you look over and she's right there, and she's like trying to play it off because she doesn't even know what's going on. Now at this point, this is where it gets a little bit tricky if you're broke as hell and got no bitches. Okay, so what you're gonna wanna do is use that to your advantage, okay? Because the thing that a lot of guys don't wanna tell you, because they're embarrassed and because it hurts their manhood, is one extremely researched, documented way to get hoes is to basically just whip out your dick, okay? Now, depending on who you are, you could get a sexual assault charge. But if you're dripped out enough, got enough, you know, if you're chalant and you got charisma and personality, it's over with. You whip out your dick. You don't show nobody except for the 10. You kind of like you know, let her see it. At this point, it's over. She wants to fuck you. So without saying anything, you look at her and you go like, you walk out to the car. You don't even look to see if she's coming. You hop in the car. You look over at the passenger window. She's out there, dude. You take her home and you do whatever the fuck you want, dude. I don't know what y'all are into. You know, I'm mostly into like piss on me and shit, but that's kind of calm, you know? Like, y'all can do whatever the fuck you want. I know y'all some freaks. You know, and when you get bitches like this, and what you'll see is that you can experiment, dude. You know, you can role play. Like, one thing I role played with, it wasn't really for me, but I tried it. I was a zookeeper, and she was a goddamn penguin. Okay, and I smashed it up. I smashed it up. It was insanely good, but it wasn't really all me, you know. I'm more into role playing as like my Elden Ring character, you know, and she can be Fia. You know, it starts with her holding me. You know, she's got on the whole Fia costume. She holds me just like in the game. And then, you know, I just back shots immediately. It's insane. Man, this video sucks ass. I'm not gonna lie. This was not the one.